Okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Christian Beal. I'm here to give an informative speech. Today on the agenda, we have my topic, which is how to save money. My general purpose is to inform. My specific purpose is to inform my audience about several easy-to-follow tips about how to save money. My thesis is that we tend to spend too much money on stuff that we don't really need. A preview of my speech is specific areas we overspend on store, energy use at home, and transportation. I can't play my PowerPoint on this projection because I have a Mac and it just didn't line up, but I have a pretty cool picture of the Wolf from Wall Street because he has a lot of money. I really like that movie. In 2013, according to Credlon.com, the average consumer made an income of $64,000 a year and spent $51,000 of those dollars each year. And it's not a lot of money being saved from your annual income. How is money spent, you might wonder, you know, I'm sure you all probably know how that money is spent. It's transportation, food, insurance, apparel, entertainment, housing, cash contributions like tips at restaurants, etc., healthcare, and other expenditures. And again, that's all according to Credlon.com. There's figures here that I don't feel like saying out loud. It would have been up on the graph. We're going to break down a few of those specific areas. I'm going to give you some tips how I think you can save money in each of them. First, we have transportation. A couple ways we can save money here. We can walk or run from A to B instead of driving, biking, and taking the bus. Those are all cost-efficient alternatives. Again, I have a picture of Forrest Gump running cross country, but I can't show that. He has his beard and all his followers. Reasons to walk and run include it's free, you don't have to pay to walk anywhere really. It's healthy for you, it's good for the earth. I might sound like a hippie, but it is. And 40% of all trips are within 2 miles of your house, which means you could get to 40% of the places you're going within like 30 minutes walking, running, or even less if you're not too out of shape. And again, that's according to campusrec.illinois.edu. Reasons to bike. We have the same reasons as reasons to walk and run, along with, as long as the weather's permitting, it's even more cost and time efficient. And the cost of buying and maintaining a bike will save you thousands of dollars compared to buying and maintaining a car. I'm sure all you guys know that. And no gas, obviously. Reasons to take the bus include, while it's not free, a monthly pass is a lot cheaper than owning your own car again. Costs are still eliminating here are car depreciation, gas, repairs, and parking fees for some. And we had a segue, segue onto the next section. We have Paul Blart writing on the segue. It's pretty fun. Onto food, ways we can save here are eating out less, grocery shopping smarter, and setting a monthly budget. Grocery shopping smarter, ways you can do this, buy your fruits and vegetables in season because there's plenty of them and they're cheaper and tastier that way. Buy in bulk, but in order to do that, you should set a meal schedule as well because that helps you avoid waste, which is waste of food and money, and just cut out the non-essential items that you don't you tend to pick up every month at the store. According to Yahoo.com, the average American spends about $2,500 a year eating out. That's over $200 a month, so if you could even cut that in half, that's you still got to pay some money at home to eat, but it's a lot cheaper eating out, and you'd say about $100 a month eating out less. Set a budget again. This kind of just you can apply this to all your financial burdens in life, but it helps you track and manage your money, which is good. Housing. All I have for housing is watch your energy usage at home. Open your windows, turn off the AC, and wash your dishes instead of running the dishwasher. Reduce your shower time if you can. And get rid of your cable. If you can like buy Hulu or Netflix, it's the same thing really to me. And to end my presentation today, I had a really cool slide of a baby on top of a big pile of money. You won't get to see it, guys. Sorry. Thank you for your time, and yes, thank you very much. Have a good day.
You're welcome.